All right. So, I've actually been coming, doing a couple different takes of this because I've made some calls on the piano voicings, the key, the chords. I'm not going to get too far into that, but I'm going to explain it anyways, or how I came to make that decision. The main goals of this video are to start making the music. So we're going to create some instrument tracks and get our MIDI programming going. I'm going to start with piano or chords of some kind. I'm going to change those things, haven't made my creative vision entirely, but definitely, you know, if not an electric piano and some pads, like some kind of combination there for a lush feel to it. So we're going to make some tracks. I always highlight my lowest track because that is where my next tracks will go, and that's where I want them to go. So I'm going to make a stereo instrument track. This is going to be for the keys. I'll hit the plus sign. I'm going to make a mono instrument track for the drums. I'm going to hit plus again, and I'm going to make a stereo master fader because we always need a stereo master fader. I'll talk about the mono versus stereo some other time. These tracks came up a bit small, so I'm going to click on that piano looking roll, and I'm going to make them medium, as well as my master fader. I'm going to go back up and I'm going to make a click track because we always want to have a click track. This one I don't want down here, so I'm going to pick it up and move it to the very top. I'm going to make that one a bit smaller, and I'm going to mute it for the moment. You know, this again would check our tempo mapping, which once again, just as a quick review, we went ahead and tempo mapped. I tempo mapped the first 10 measures. There are some spots I'm a little iffy about, like a change from 70 to 71. If we could go back, we can. If we were to combine these measures and the map thereof, we could get like a 72 average, which might be a little more accurate. At where we left off, I'm predicting that we'll need to go back and do some mapping at some point pretty soon. In any case, I'm also, reminder, working in Pro Tools, so I'm going to try and make references to Pro Tools first for significant things that might be different. I'm going to go ahead and insert the multi-channel plugin instrument called Expand. That is what we all have access to. I'm going to go ahead and choose from the e-piano category the very first choice, the Mark II, good old kind of Fender-ish suitcase Rhodes. And I can hide that. I don't need to see it anymore for the moment. Now, here's where I need to talk about for a little bit. So I actually have found a number of different resources. I have this Synthesia that shows some very basic chords. I have my E chords tab, where I essentially have, you know, it on keyboard view. So when I roll over these, I'm actually seeing the notes that need to play. And this one is basically the same as this. Then I found this one, which is more, I guess you'd call it like a piano arrangement, where the left hand and the right hand kind of play together to make up the voicing of the chord. And I did like it, except that as it descends, it's going to be an ad, you know, it goes down, 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 no, that goes up, down, you know, whatever. And in the original song, the chords go up, and I wanted to make sure that I got that feel, that sound. Now, there's some things called inversions. So when this chord is playing G, B, and E, it is actually still, you know, the same as the C chord that's being played here, C, E, G. The notes are the same in that you have C in the bass, but you have a different voicing up here. So I ended up kind of combining the two a little bit, mostly because of this where the verse gets to those ocean eyes, there's G, D, C. So it changes, and I didn't really like how that was coming out. And then I didn't really like the way that this one had it. So it's a combination thereof. And I'm still not 100% sold. We may go back and change the voicings at some point. Anyhow, I'm pretty confident that I'm going to stick with these for the moment. We have our sound. In Pro Tools first, we have highlighted the nameplate and brought up our MIDI editor. In Pro Tools, you actually have the track selector. So selecting the nameplate doesn't actually do that for you. You have to click over here. And in Pro Tools, you also have your MIDI editor here, which you still need to highlight, select, and you can work there. I'm going to work in here because most of the people following along, I think, will be working in first. So I'm not even going to look at those pictures right now because I've written this down. And maybe I'll insert a slide in here if I edit, but probably not, just being honest. I do want to have my grid at 16th notes. For Pro Tools first, you're actually clicking up here. It's not here, it's here, and it affects both. So please make sure that you're in 16th notes because our chords play in 3/16th intervals. So the first note is G, C for 3/16th notes. And I'm going to be in the third octave for now. I may change that and bring it down. We'll see. Or I'll just add some bass notes. So C, E for 3, and G. And you can hear that. The next chord is A, and that goes up. Is that really? A, D, E? No, going down. A, D. This one's in the wrong spot. And F sharp. A, D, F sharp. Yeah, that sounds pretty good. And then B, E, G, beg. B, and that goes out to the end of the first measure. B, E, and G. All right, so we have the first chord and the third chord share those two notes and change only in the lower note. Okay, so once again, C, E, G, A, D, F sharp, B, E, G. Hide this for the moment because that repeats. Until here. So that was, once again, highlight with the grabber. One more reminder that if you are using the Smart Tool, which you should, if you are below the midpoint of any given track, you can use the grabber tool. Above the midpoint is the selector tool. And then for duplicating, once you highlight it, on a Mac it is Command D, and on a PC Control D. Or edit, duplicate, and remind yourself. So now, that's not how Pro Tools first works. The fourth time, in the fourth measure, so it goes up. So we are going to have our first chord is actually B. Still same rhythmic pattern, so 3/16th notes, B, D, and G. And then, interesting, same notes, different order, D, G. Oh, they're in the wrong place. D, G, and B. So just move those over. And then the last one is C, E, G. C. E. And G. So we may revisit this again in terms of the voicings, just to get a sense of what it sounds like. All right, we're about 11-12 minutes in, so this gets us the opportunity to do some duplicating. Let's just listen.
I've been watching you for some time. Can't stop staring at those ocean eyes.
Okay, this whole pattern repeats again. So click with your grabber tool on the first one, hold down shift, select the other one. The reason it's so important that it's the grabber is that we know we have these four measures selected with nothing else. If I'm trying to hit that with the selector, I might get some extra, and that's not good. So that's a good point in using the grabber, and we're going to duplicate the whole thing. So Command D or Control D.
I've been watching you for some time. Can't stop staring at those ocean eyes. Burning cities and napalm skies.
Same thing. That time, this second part repeats, so I can hear that. So we're gonna take this last clip, duplicate it.
Inside those ocean eyes, your ocean eyes will fall.
Okay, it does go back to this first thing. I'm not sure what I'm going to do yet. let's go ahead. What does it
do? You really know how to make me cry when you give me those ocean eyes. I'm scared.
Okay, so this doesn't have that duplicate. Here's something that I don't know how to do this on a PC. So highlight the first one, select, highlight through, but not the duplicate. We can hit Control C and copy it. We can place our cursor where it needs to go. There, and hit Command V, same thing, gets us there. You can hear that the map is off already. So, yeah, we're off. So that's good. It's good to just pause there and start putting in the drums. And for the moment, so let's see. What drums to use? I'm going to stick with expand for the moment. Maybe I should have thought about this ahead of time. I think I'm going to start with these warm drums. No real reason yet. Drums come in at measure 9 with a kick drum. So, drum drums are selected. Don't need to see the keys. And I can go all the way to measure 9. And on C1, my kick drum. Yeah. Burning sea, burning sea, burning sea. I don't know if I'm going to do it exactly. Burning season. Probably going to move on from this drum kit very quickly. Burning season, napalm skies, thick eyes. Okay, so we have kick on beat 1. Then on the 2nd and 3rd 16th notes of beat 2 of measure 9, snare on beat 4. Beat 1 of measure 10, same thing here. Beats 16th note, 2nd and 3rd 16th note of beat 2. Snare on 4. Kick immediately on 2nd 16th note. Burning season, napalm skies. Okay, so this is a time where I'm going to already bring up this idea of velocity, especially... But it just, we need it to be bigger. We need all this to be bigger. And you want 100%. And then with this one, cocoon, this one, we definitely want that first one to be lower. Because that is going to give at least a beginning sense of more natural drumming. When you do a double hit like that on a kick drum, ta-dum, that your foot is going to hit that first one slightly lighter, at least, you know, tends to be. Burning season, napalm skies. Okay, now. 15 flares inside those ocean eyes, your ocean. So I'm going to take this whole thing and duplicate it, but if we follow exactly along, it doesn't play this part here, it plays it. Ocean eyes, your ocean eyes. But anyways, I'm going to place my cursor at measure 12, Command E or Control E, and cut it. I'm going to move this one over to be measure 13. I'm going to come and take measure 11 and duplicate it. Burning season, napalm skies. Some high notes come in. 15 flares inside those ocean eyes. Your ocean eyes. Yeah, tempo map already. All right, so I'm going to jump in. I'm going to tempo map. 15 flares inside those 15. Ooh, okay, that's not a good cut. So I'm going to go and undo that. There it is. Is it? 15 flares inside those 15. I'm going to undo that. I'm going to go here. Or here. Oh, no. Slip mode, people. 15 flares inside those 15. It's a little early. Shoot. 15 flares inside those 15. I just don't want it to get all the way here where it was. Let's see that. 15 flares inside those 15 flares inside those 15. All right, cut it there. Command I, 12, 72.2. OK, okay, if you're getting things different, just know that this was an eyeball here.
Ocean eyes, you're
that one looks better.
Ocean eyes,
oops, what happened?
Ocean eyes,
Four. Okay, let's see how that sounds. Quit this. That one still sounds funky. All right, here we go.
Burning cities in napalm skies.
On this, on measure 11,
15.
I don't know if I heard it in the original.
15.
Yeah, I just hear a hi-hat. I hear it in the vocal too.
15.
Right? And it just kind of inspired me that I'm going to put it in there anyways. I'm going to raise the velocities. Okay, so I think that's good to start, and we will kind of end it there, make this hopefully digestible.